Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, we're going to graph f of x equals absolute value of x minus 3 minus 4. All right, so you want to do it the easy way to find the vertex. We see what makes the absolute value 0, because that'll be the minimum smallest number that will go in the absolute value. So we take x minus 3, set it equal to 0, and that gives us the x coordinate of the vertex. Now if we plug in 3, right, we'll be able to figure out what y value goes with that. So if we put in 3 for x, of course, this absolute value becomes 0, so we have 0 minus 4. So the vertex will be 3, negative 4, which is right here, 3, negative 4. All right, now at this point, you could plug in a couple ordered pairs, or you can find, let's say, the y-intercept. That might be an easy one to do. So we're going to just plug in any value you want. How about if you plug in 0 for x? If you plug in 0 for x, you get the absolute value of negative 3, which is 3, right? So think about that. You're going to get 3 minus 4, which is negative 1. So we have an ordered pair here. Now, the cool thing is, if this vertex right here is along this vertical line, there's a corresponding one on the other side. So notice that's the order pair 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, negative 1. 6, negative 1 should also be an order pair, and you could plug that in and see if you really do get that order pair. So if you put in 6 for x up here, you get absolute value of 3, which is 3, and 3 minus 4, yes, is negative 1. So see how I've got that? And once you've got two ordered pairs, two more ordered pairs, you can graph this. Now, another way some people do this is they also dot in this line. And then they kind of pretend like that's the origin. All right? This is called the x prime and y prime axis sometimes. People call it that. And then they just graph f of y equals absolute value of x over 1 and up 1, over 1 and up 2, over 1 and up 3, over 1 and up 4, etc. And you would get a bunch of ordered pairs on that. So that's another technique I like to use, actually. Instead of plugging in the real numbers, I know if that's the vertex, if I was graphing y equals absolute value of x, you get the ordered pairs, 1, 1, 2, 2, etc. And what you do is from this new vertex, or from the vertex, you just go over 1 and up 1, over 2 and up 2. Over 3 and up 3, over 4 and up 4, and also in the opposite direction. A couple ways to get it. All right, so we've got our vertex. Let's just do our domain and range quickly. The domain is always all real numbers because x could be anything. And the range, what's the bottom of the range? Well, it just means what's the y value of the vertex right over here at negative 4. So our range, the lowest it could ever be, is at negative 4, but it goes up forever. That's why I put arrows here to show it goes on forever and ever. All right, here's the next one to try. So why don't you put the video on pause and try this one on your own first? Okay, let's start off with the vertex. All right, remember to get the x coordinate. We take what's in the absolute value, which is 2x plus 4. Set it equal to 0. So we know that the x coordinate of our vertex is negative 2. Right, then when we plug that in, we'll be able to find the y value. So when you plug in negative 2 for x, of course, you'll get absolute value of 0 because that's the whole point. You chose a value of x to make this absolute value equal to 0, so you'll get 0 plus 1. So this number over here ends up being your your y coordinate of your vertex. Look at the previous problem. See what happened when I plugged in 3? It automatically made this 0. So this value, negative 4, was your y coordinate. So same thing's going to happen here. That 1 will be the y coordinate for this. So we've got negative 2, 1. That's our vertex point, right? Now we could do it a few different ways from here. If you want, you could just dot in because there's some symmetry going on here. You could use it for symmetry, you could pretend that's your new axis. All you need is a couple more points and you should be able to graph this. So let's see, how about if we plug in 0 for x? So what happens when you plug in 0 for x? Right, so in other words, put in 0 for x in the original equation up here. You'll get the absolute value of 4, which is 4 plus 1. So that'll be 5. So when you put in 0 for x, you get 5. So I know that this is another ordered pair on this. So there should be 1 on the other side. Okay. And that's really enough to get the idea. But if you want, you could plug in another ordered pair. Like you could see what happens when x equals negative 1. What would happen when you plugged in negative 1 for x? You'd have 4 minus 2 in the parentheses, so you'd have the absolute value of negative 2, which is 2. And 2 plus 1 is 3. So if you want, you could get more ordered pairs. So notice this one is steeper looking than the other ones we've done so far. And that is because it looks kind of like the line y equals 2x plus 4 in that the slope is the coefficient of x. Okay? So that's something kind of interesting that you might notice. This is part of the line y equals 2x plus 4. But the main thing I want you to see is that it is a line that has a slope of 2, and over here on the left is the slope of negative 2, right? So you will have a positive and a negative slope, really. But these are not lines because it stops at the vertex. So we've got our vertex, which is what we wanted, and now it should be easy to do the domain and range. The domain is always negative infinity to infinity. And the range, what happens? If it's going up like it is, the lowest point is whatever the y value of the vertex is. So, and you can see that. That's the low point of the graph is when y is 0. So it's 1 to infinity. So I want to clarify something. I said some people think of this as your x prime and your y prime axis, but in this case, you can't just graph y equals absolute value of x. Think of it as graphing the line y equals 2x, and you'll be okay. So if it has a coefficient in front of the x, you would have to use that slope over 1 and up 2, etc. Over 1 and up 2, over 2 and up 4, and you would get it if you wanted to use that technique I showed you in the last one. So if there's a coefficient of x, that does change how steep these parts of lines are that you see. You'll also have to be careful if there is a coefficient in front of the absolute value, and we'll be getting to problems like that as well. Right, here's our next problem. Feel free to put the video on pause and try it on your own first. So we've got f of x equals absolute value of 1/2 x minus 2 in absolute value signs minus 1. All right, so we need to get the vertex first, and so what we need to do is take what's in the absolute value and set it equal to 0 because that'll give us the smallest number possible in the absolute value, which will be a 0, and solve for x. So to solve this, you could add 2 to both sides and then multiply both sides by 2. Or you can multiply both sides by 2 first and solve it that way. There's different ways of solving equations with fractions. All right, so this is x equals 4. So my vertex point, my x value will be 4. And what will the y value be? It will just be this minus 1 out in front. Because when you plug in 4, you should get absolute value of 0. So you'll have 0 minus 1. So we've got 4, negative 1 for our vertex. Okay. Now, there's a couple ways you can go from here. You could plug in any number you want for x and find another value, but you know there's going to be some symmetry. So I like to draw this line to remember there's some symmetry here. So let's say you're going to plug in the number 0 for x, what would you get? So if you put in 0 for x, you get the absolute value of negative 2, which is 2, and 2 minus 1 is 1. So I know 0, 1 is on my graph, so there's a corresponding number over here, right? 4 to the right, and that's how I can get my graph right there. Usually that's a nice easy way to do it. If the vertex is not on the y-axis, to plug in 0 for x, that gives you one order pair, and then you get another one for free on the other side, and you're done. Another way that you could think of it is this. You should get, because there's no coefficient except one out in here, this number in front of the x represents the slope. So you'll have a plus and minus slope. So another way to do it is if from this vertex point you do a slope of 1/2, you go over 2 and up 1, you'll get this point here. Go over 2 and up 1, you'll get this point here. And in the negative direction, you would go negative 2 and up 1, negative 2 and up 1. That's another way people get a couple more order pairs. Just make sure that those order pairs really are on the graph. So in other words, make the equation true. So this order pair, 2, 0, when you put in 2 for x, make sure that when you plug in 2 for x, y or f of x will be 0. So what happens? Plug in 2 for x, you get 1/2 of 2 is 1, 1 minus 2 is negative 1. When you take that absolute value, you get positive 1. And yes, 1 minus 1 is 0. So this really is an order pair on your graph. So in summarizing this a little bit, to get the vertex point, you know that to get the x value of the vertex point, you set whatever's inside the absolute value to equal to 0, and then this number, so this will be equal to 0, right? You're gonna see, I'm gonna move this down a little bit so you can write that. Set equal to 0. Okay, I know that's not perfect math terms, but this will be your y coordinate of vertex. Set equal to 0 to get x coordinate. Okay, so those are very important things. That's going to be true always to get your vertex. You're going to set what's in the absolute value equal to 0 to get the x coordinate, and this number over here, if you have a number, is going to be the y coordinate. If there is no number, you could think of it as plus 0, and that would be your y coordinate of your vertex. The last thing we need to write down here are the domain and range. So the domain, that's always the same, isn't it? X can be anything. So it's from negative infinity to positive infinity. And the range, all right, there's a bottom number, right? So what's the lowest y value? It's negative 1. Always, it's the y coordinate of the vertex. So from negative 1 to infinity. This will be true for any absolute value function that is going up. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.